The purpose of this video is to show you some of the useful tools and features that are provided in Oxygen to help you work with JSON documents. The possibilities include converting JSON to XML and XML to JSON, converting XSD to JSON schema, generating sample JSON files from a JSON schema, generating JSON schema from a JSON instance. In the first section of the video, I will show you the built-in tools for converting JSON to and from XML and an add-on that can be used to convert multiple files at once. First, I'll discuss the JSON to XML converter tool. I will use an already created JSON file that is basically a simple collection of book titles with numerous book properties that contain information such as the author, publisher, and a short description. The JSON to XML tool is found in the JSON Tools submenu inside the Tools menu. This opens a very simple dialog box where you specify the URL of an input JSON file and the location for the resulting XML file. Note that the input URL is automatically set to the currently open JSON file, while the output file is set to an automatically generated path to an XML file in the current directory. The conversion process is quite straightforward. Each JSON property is converted to an XML element, and the value of the property is added as a child of that element. Oxygen also includes a tool for converting XML files to JSON. This type of conversion is created using a similar dialog box, but in this case, you specify the URL of an XML file for the input, and it results in a converted JSON file. The conversion process transforms the XML elements into JSON properties and the child elements into the corresponding JSON property values. Those two conversion tools are for individual files, but Oxygen also offers support for batch converting multiple files at once. To do this, you need to install an additional add-on that provides numerous batch conversion actions. More information about this add-on can be found in the Oxygen User Guide. But for the purposes of this video, I already installed the add-on, so I'll show you how to use it to convert a set of JSON files to XML. I have a folder that contains a set of JSON files. The add-on that I talked about contributes a batch converter submenu in the contextual menu in the project view. So I will select and right-click my set of JSON files, and I'll select JSON to XML from the batch converter submenu. The files to be converted are displayed in the resulting dialog box. By default, the output is set to be saved in an output folder inside the current folder. And I want the Open Files and Editor option to be selected so that I can view the output XML files. For every JSON file, the converter produces a similarly named XML file. More details about these other types of conversions can also be found in our user guide. Next, if you want to impose restrictions on the JSON structure and take advantage of Oxygen's special JSON editing support, such as content completion, validation, and more, you need to associate a JSON schema to your JSON document. If you already have an XML schema and you want to generate a similar JSON schema, then you can use the XSD to JSON schema converter tool. This tool is also found in the JSON Tools submenu inside the Tools menu. This tool also requires an additional add-on, so the first time you use the action, you will be asked to install it. The process is very simple. You just follow the on-screen instructions, and at the end of the installation process, you will need to restart Oxygen. Now I can use the converter action again, and a simple dialog box is displayed that allows me to choose the XSD file and the location of the resulting output file. I kept the Open in Editor option selected, so the resulting JSON schema is automatically opened in the main editor. In most cases, the conversion creates an equivalent schema. and you can find more details about this tool in the Oxygen User Manual as well. Oxygen also includes a tool for generating sample JSON files starting from a JSON schema file. To show you this, I'll generate some sample instance files based on a JSON schema file that defines a simple HR structure. This tool is called Generate Sample JSON Files, and it is also found in the JSON Tools submenu. I'll choose my JSON schema as the input file. The output folder is automatically set to the current folder, but you can edit that. This tool includes several other options. For example, I can choose to associate the schema to each instance. I can change the resulting file name. I can choose the desired number of JSON instances to be generated. I can also specify the way the values of the properties are generated. If I select the Generate Optional Properties option, the JSON instance will be generated with optional properties that are defined in the JSON schema. If I select the Generate Additional Content option, the JSON instance will be generated with additional properties that are defined in the JSON schema or additional items in the case of an array. And there are some additional options that I'll leave as is. I kept the Open First Instance and Editor option selected, so after I click Generate, the first generated instance is opened in the editor. And you can see the other generated instances in the project view. If you already have a JSON instance and you want to define a JSON schema for it, you can use the Generate JSON Schema action. To show you this, I have a JSON file that contains information about some people, and I want to create a JSON schema for it. The Generate JSON Schema action is also located in the JSON Tools submenu. And in the resulting dialog box, I'll select the JSON document as the input file, and you can choose the location of the resulting JSON schema. There are also some other options available in the dialog box. For example, if I select the Extract Matching Format for Strings option, the tools will find a suitable format for various string values from the JSON document. For example, an email format will be set for a string that represents an email address. If I select the Restrict Additional Content option, additional properties for objects and additional items for arrays will be set to false in the resulting schema. Again, I kept the Open and Editor option selected, so after I click Generate, the generated schema is opened in the main editor. And I can now validate the JSON instance file with the generated schema. The validation was successful, but to see if the tool works, I'll intentionally introduce a typo in the email address property value. Now, when I validate the JSON file against the generated schema, the error is reported. So those are the main tools provided by Oxygen to help you work with JSON files. This concludes the demonstration, and as always, thank you for watching.